Hello, I'm Dr. Payal Dande, and welcome back to our learning video on high performance thin layer chromatography, which is a sophisticated and automated form of TLC. In our last session of part 1, we had completed talking about the development of the method which is done using the different instruments which are available under HPTLC. Now further, we are going to discuss and see how do they look like, what is their use, what is their application, as well as how to utilize it. So first, talking about the HPTLC plates and the twin trough chambers which are used for the development of chromatogram. The HPTLC plates are already available in the pre-coated form from the various companies. The most well-known companies are Anchrom, Chemag. Now over here, there are different sizes which are available. Like we may have the plate of let's say 20 by 20, which comes in a pack, 10 by 10 centimeter, as well as 5 by 5 centimeter and 5 by 10 centimeter. So depending upon what we require, we can choose a particular size of the plate. This plate is basically made up of an aluminium plate, which is forming a base, and over that the various adsorbents are being spreaded. The sizes, the pore size, as well as the width of the different adsorbent will vary depending upon the use. So some may have a very large pore size, some may have a very small one. Similarly, the major adsorbent which we use, as I said, is silica. Although we have different other adsorbents like silica, alumina and cellulose. Now coming to the twin trough chamber, this is how the twin trough chambers look. And why they are called twin trough is because we have a trough over here in between, which is being made up of glass, and thereby we get two different faces. And above there is a lid to make sure that the solvent does not get evaporated. Now, how is this more useful or advantageous than other chambers which we use normally in the lab? So this twin trough chamber, first of all, allows us to use very less solvent. So there is low solvent consumption. Second, it can help us in increasing the reproducibility as well as to attain the pre-equilibration with the solvent vapor. You can even keep a filter paper over here and make sure that the whole procedures of saturation is in a quick. That means we can actually make it fast. And the third, we have the gas phase conditioning with any conditioning liquid or volatile reagent that is possible in this twin trough chamber. So these are the advantage and sophistications that are available with the HPTLC instrumentation. The next, we come to the sample applicator. There are several sample applicators which are available. Earlier we used to have this as the semi automated applicators, and now we have fully automated applicators for the sample. So this is our plate, and in semi automated applicators, usually the only part which was manual was to clean the injector, to fill it and to put it. That's it. The rest was already programmed in terms of how much quantity needs to be applied on the plate and to what distance. Nowadays we have completely automated sampler where we can even make sure that the sample is being automatically filled in the injector, and once the program is set, it will apply the sample onto the plate as per the program in the form of distance and as many number of spots which you have asked for. Now the sample application can be done in two forms. One is called as spot application, the other is called as narrow bands. The narrow bands give you more better separation and optimization. Further, you can apply the solution only on planar medium. As you can see over there, these are the pre-coated TLC plates which we have used for applying the sample, and all these instruments are complying with the requirements of GMP and GLP. Beside this, they also helps us to develop a validated methods with making it everything very precise and keeping it calibrated. The next important part of the instrument which we use is the densitometer scanner. This is a very important part because this helps us to actually evaluate our chromatogram which is being generated on the TLC plate. So once we have developed the chromatogram, we have to keep the TLC plate inside. This is the opening. You have to keep the TLC plate inside fixed, and then you will be able to see and scan all the details on the software which is available with our desktop. And this is how you can evaluate the different chromatograms. So this chromatogram basically is seen under the UV light. So we have a UV detector where we can evaluate our plate. So if the chromatogram has developed, it's showing the separation which is done. So this is under 254 nanometer. This is under 366 nanometer under UV light, where we can see the different spots getting fluoresced. This is also because of the silica which we use, the type of silica plate or silica gel which we use. And finally, if this plates does not show the spots, or these spots are do not have a chromophore and they cannot be visualized under UV light, then you can go for derivatization, meaning you can use certain chemicals for spraying onto the plate, which will react with the spots and give them the color. And finally, you will find something like this in the visible daylight. So these are the plates. And you can photo document in any form. You can photo document the plates before derivatization, that is under UV, and even after derivatization. So this is something which is amazingly beautiful about HPTLC. Now beside this, the chromatogram can be seen in the form of peaks. Can you see this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is called as the area under curve. And this helps us in quantification. So basically, we'll be able to know what is the quantity available in different samples. And there could be different samples which can be run. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So many samples which can be run together. So these are the major advantages which you have with respect to HPTLC technique. Now let us see its application, where all it is being applied. So it is applied in pharmaceutical industry for identification, for purification, separation, isolation, quality control, stability testing, and also for content uniformity assay. It is very commonly being used in research and development for the isolation of phytochemicals, purification of synthetic compound, as well as for the development of validated methods. They are sometimes even used in clinical projects to evaluate biological samples in preclinical and clinical studies, as well as in some metabolism studies. Besides this, this is the method of choice in herbal medicines and dietary supplements for the identification, for assay, for detection of adulteration, as well as for stability testing. Besides this, there are several other industries which are using HPTLC technique. For example, food and drug analysis, which use it for the quality control and detection of additives, substitutes, pesticides and other aflatoxins. The other industries which use it for the development and optimization of different processes, as well as for cleaning validation of the instrument. Some cosmetic industries use it for the content determination, and the forensic investigation, which is most important, they use it for the detection of poisoning material. They also can find out the dye stuffs which are used, and they identify if there is any forgery of document which has happened by knowing about the color and the type of ink which is utilized. So isn't it interesting to know about the uses and application of HPTLC so worldwide in different industries? So finally, you must be getting the answer of why HPTLC. Why HPTLC? We should use it because it helps us to automate the different steps. It helps us to increase our resolution of the chromatogram. It helps in using the different particle size, rather different pore size of the adsorbent, which helps in high resolution. It allows us to get more accurate quantitative measurements. It also helps to overcome the uncertainty in the sampling size by using the sample applicator. And moreover, this is most important because it can actually help us for multi-sampling. That means so many analysts can work together. And the evaluation is possible in different forms. You can use the retention factor, you can see the fluorescence, you can photo document the plates, as well as you can go for qualitative and quantitative estimation of chromatogram in the software by using the scanner. So overall, the advantage of HPTLC is that we use low solvent, We do not have a very huge procedure of cleanup like we see it in other instruments like HPLC and so on. Pre-washing of the plate are required sometimes. Densitometry scanning of individual and all fractions are possible. Evaluation or documenting the fractions can be done before as well as after derivatizing the plate. 15 to 20 samples can be evaluated just within a time of 1 hour, say 60 minutes. And this can even be done simultaneously together at a time. A huge amount of data can be actually obtained from the chromatogram which we have developed, and photo and video documentation both are possible for the research and development. Finally, to conclude, HPTLC is a very important qualitative and quantitative technique which helps us in determination of different analyte and for separation of mixture. It is the most simple, effective and easy method to perform. It's cost effective and also time efficient. This can be used for various estimations together at a time. I have already said photo and video documentation is possible and the methods are validated and reproducible. Thank you so much for listening to our lecture. Now we'll be coming up with the in-class activity. Thank you so much. These are the various key references which we have utilized to make up this learning video. Thank you. So here is Payal Dande signing off.